Three European nations declare their recognition of Palestine as an independent state. Norway, Ireland, and Spain made separate announcements today. Norway's prime minister says they hope the recognition will help bring peace to the Middle East. The formal declaration will be released on May 28th.
The recognition of Palestine is in support of moderate forces that are on a retreating front in a protracted and cruel conflict. This is an investment in the only solution that can bring lasting peace in the Middle East. It is a strong call to other countries to do the same as we are doing today. In the midst of a war with tens of thousands dead and injured, we must keep alive the only thing that can provide a safe home for both Israelis and Palestinians. Two states that can live in peace with each other, Israel and Palestine.
Slovenia and Malta in recent weeks have also indicated they plan to make similar declarations. Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei presided over the funeral service for the late President Ebrahim Raisi, his foreign minister, and others killed in a helicopter crash on Sunday. The program was held at Tehran University following the procession of their caskets through the capital. Among those who attended the service were acting President Mohammad Mokhber and leaders of Iran's paramilitary Revolutionary Guard. Iran has declared 5 days of mourning following the tragedy.
Vietnam's top cop Tho Lam is elected as state president by the National Assembly. While the role is largely ceremonial, analysts see his appointment as a potential stepping stone for the position of chief of the ruling Communist Party. As head of the Public Security Ministry, Lam has been at the center of a sweeping anti-graft campaign aimed at rooting out widespread corruption in government. The state presidency is one of Vietnam's top four political positions. The others are the party chief, the prime minister, and the parliament speaker. Tech enthusiasts descend on South Korea today, Wednesday, for a global forum on artificial intelligence. Companies joining this year's summit include U.S. tech giants OpenAI, Google, and Microsoft, all at the forefront of developing AI. South Korean Prime Minister Han Duck-soo stressed the importance of ensuring safety in AI. He spoke at the summit's opening with a call to also make the technology more accessible across the globe.
Safety, strength, public trust in AI. No one can deny that safety features are a critical element that determines the competitive edge and sustainability of AI models in the global market. AI safety cannot be truly achieved until those who are the most vulnerable have access to necessary means to respond to threats and challenges posed by this new technology.
Authorities have determined the cause of the fire that razed over a dozen vehicles at the parking lot of the Naia Terminal 3 last month. Our correspondent Robert Mano now on the line with the details. Robert?
Denise, the management of the Manila International Airport Authority has received the report from the Bureau of Fire Protection regarding the cause of the fire in the parking extension of Naia Terminal 3, where 20 vehicles were burned last April 22, 2024. According to MIAA General Manager Eric Jose Ines, the BFP report indicates that the fire was caused by a cigarette butt. Ines also mentioned that they are now ensuring the area is clean by removing dry leaves, adding gravel, installing lights, and increasing the number of CCTV cameras. Regular checks of the parking area are also being conducted. The PSI, which operates the Naia Terminal 3 extension parking, has already spoken with the owners of the burned vehicles. Denise.
Thanks for that, Robert.